Today I'll be taking bacterial toxins part 2. Starting from cholera toxin. Cholera toxin secreted by Vibrio cholerae. The mechanism of action of cholera toxin. It is two peptide fragments, fragment A and fragment B. Fragment B is the binding fragment, which is pentameric, having 5 subunits. It binds to the GM1 ganglioside receptors on intestinal epithelium. Then fragment A gets internalized, cleaved into A1 and A2 peptides. Fragment A2 helps in tethering of A and B subunits. Fragment A1 is the active fragment. Here you can clearly see in the diagram, fragment A1 is the active fragment which causes ADP ribosylation of G protein, that is G inhibitory subunit. It upregulates the activity of adenylate cyclase, leading to intracellular accumulation of cyclic AMP, which causes increased outflow of water and electrolytes into the gut lumen, causing watery diarrhea. Then comes E. coli toxin, which is Escherichia coli toxins. Escherichia coli toxins, heat labile toxin, is secreted by enterotoxigenic E. coli, which is plasmid coated. The mechanism of action is fragment B is the binding fragment, which is pentameric, having 5 subunits. It binds to GM1 ganglioside receptor on intestinal epithelium. Fragment A gets internalized, clips into A1 and A2 peptides, and fragment A2 helps in tethering of the A1 and B subunits. Its mechanism of action is quite similar to that of the cholera toxin. Fragment A, here you can clearly see in the picture that fragment A1 is the active fragment. It causes ADP ribosylation of G protein, which upregulates the activity of adenylate cyclase, causing intracellular accumulation of CAM, which causes increased outflow of water and electrolytes into the gut lumen, causing watery diarrhea. Then comes heat stable toxin of E. coli, which is secreted by enterotoxigenic E. coli. It is plasmid coated. Its mechanism of action is that the heat stable toxin 1 binds to guanylate cyclase, which causes increased production of cyclic GMP, leading to fluid accumulation in the gut lumen, causing diarrhea. The verocytotoxin or striga-like toxins is secreted by enterohemorrhagic E. coli. It is bacteriophage coated. It is cytotoxic to verocell lines. It resembles striga toxin in structure and function. There are two types of striga-like toxin, striga-like toxin 1 and striga-like toxin 2. It causes hemolytic uremic syndrome, which is a thrombotic microangiopathy caused more commonly by striga-like toxin 2 more than striga-like toxin 1 and enteroaggregative E. coli 104H4. The triad of hemolytic uremic syndrome comprises of thrombocytopenia, acute renal impairment, microangiopathic hemolytic anemia. The mechanism of action of striga-like toxin. Striga toxin damages the vascular endothelium by inhibiting the protein synthesis. It causes thrombus formation and hemorrhagic manifestations. The fragment B, which is the binding fragment, binds to globotriosyl ceramide GB3 receptor on intestinal epithelium. The fragment A, which is the active fragment, inhibits protein synthesis by inhibiting the 28S subunit of 60S subunit ribosome. Detection of heat labile toxin, heat stable toxin, verocytotoxin is by toxin detection latex agglutination and ELISA. Molecular methods of detecting heat labile toxin and heat stable toxin is polymerase chain reaction detecting gene and verocytotoxin specific DNA probe. Cytotoxicity can be detected by vero and HeLa cell lines. Pertussis toxin secreted by Bordetella pertussis. The mechanism of action of pertussis toxin is that it has similarly two fragments, fragment B and fragment A. Fragment B is the binding fragment, which is pentameric, having 5 subunits. It binds to GM1 ganglioside receptor on intestinal epithelium, following which the fragment A gets internalized. Fragment A1, as we know, is the active fragment, which causes ADP ribosylation of G protein, but here it causes ADP ribosylation of G stimulatory subunit. It upregulates the activity of adenylate cyclase, causing intracellular accumulation of cyclic AMP. Intracellular accumulation of cyclic AMP leads to T cell mitogenicity, hemagglutination, adhesion to respiratory ciliated cells, inhibition of neutrophil oxidase burst, monocyte migration, histamine release from mast cell, induction of leukocytosis, enhancement of insulin secretion leading to hypoglycemia. adenylate cyclase toxin activates the cyclic AMP, impairs host immune function. Dermonecrotic toxin causes respiratory mucosal damage. Its clinical importance is that detection of serum antibodies, that is enzyme immunoassays, using purified antigens. Anthrax toxin is secreted by Bacillus anthracis. It is a tripartite toxin, A to B, which has three fragments. Edema factor is the factor 1. Protective antigen factor is the factor 2. Lethal factor is the factor 3. Toxin synthesis is controlled by plasmid PX01. PA83 binds to the AT receptor. PA20 gets cleaved off from PA83, which are the membrane endoproteases from furin family. PA63, which are the receptor bound portion, binds with the edema factor or lethal factor and enters the cell. The mechanism is called endocytosis, which you can clearly see in the picture given. In cytosol, the edema factor acts as calcium and calmodulin dependent adenylate cyclase, increases the intracellular cyclic AMP levels. Imbalance in water homeostasis, intracellular signaling pathway and macrophage function is caused. Lethal factor acts as zinc dependent endoprotease. It sneaks up the end terminus of MAP kinase, which is mitosin activated protein kinase. Inhibition of MAP kinase leads to altered signaling pathways causing apoptosis. Shiga toxin. It is a verotoxin secreted by Shigella dysentery serotype 1. The mechanism of action is, it has two fragments, fragment A and fragment B. Fragment B binds to the globotriosyl ceramide GB3 receptor on intestinal epithelium, which you can clearly see in that picture. Fragment A is the active fragment. It inhibits the protein synthesis by inhibiting 28S subunit of 60S subunit ribosome. It enhances local vascular damage of intestine as well as internal organs such as kidney and brain. Shigella enterotoxin 1 and 2. Shigella enterotoxin 1 is structurally similar to cholera toxin, that is S flexneri 2A. Shigella enterotoxin type 2 is of Shigella flexneri isolates, resulting in iron uptake. It has two peptide fragments, fragment A and fragment B. Fragment B is the binding fragment, which is pentameric, having 5 subunits. It binds to GM1 ganglioside receptor on intestinal epithelium, following which fragment A gets internalized. Then it clips into A1 and A2 peptides. Fragment A2 results in tethering of fragment A and B subunits. Fragment A1 is the active fragment, causes ADP ribosylation of G protein, upregulate the activity of adenylate cyclase, intracellular accumulation of cyclic AMP, increase outflow of water and electrolytes into gut lumen, causing watery diarrhea. The mechanism of action of Shigella enterotoxin is similar to that of cholera toxin. Coming to Corynebacterium diphtheriae toxin, which is the diphtheria toxin, it is the primary virulence factor. It has two fragments. Fragment B is the binding fragment. It binds toxin to host cell receptor. Fragment A is the active fragment, which gets internalized into the cell, which you can see in the given picture. Following internalization of fragment A, there is ADP ribosylation of elongation factor 2, leading to inhibition of elongation factor 2, which causes inhibition of translational step of protein synthesis. Toxicity of diphtheria bacillus depends on phase coded by beta corynephages carrying tox gene. Lysogenic or phase conversion, non-toxigenic strains render toxigenic by infecting them with beta prophase. This you can see the characteristic membrane formation in case of diphtheria infection. Pseudomonas aeruginosa. It produces non-diffusible toxins and diffusible toxins. Non-diffusible toxins are exotoxin ACUTY. Injects toxin via type 3 secretion system into the host cell. Bacteria by their cytotoxic activity evade the phagocytic cell, causing tissue injury. Diffusible toxins are exotoxin A, which is secreted by organisms type 2 secretion system, causing tissue injury. Here you can see Pseudomonas aeruginosa causes malignant otitis externa ear. In malignant otitis externa, the ear is extremely painful on touch. It also causes nosocomial infection in the ICU and burn patients. It causes pneumonia leading to cystic fibrosis. It causes osteomyelitis, ecthyma gangrenosum, hot tub folliculitis, burn wound infection, septicemia, endotoxic shock leading to death. Mechanism of action. It has two fragments. Fragment B is the binding fragment and fragment A is the active fragment. The whole mechanism you can see in the picture. Fragment B, which is the binding fragment, binds to the host cell receptor, which you can see in the picture. Fragment A is the active fragment, which gets internalized. ADP causes ADP ribosylation of elongation factor 2. Following ADP ribosylation of elongation factor 2, there will be inhibition of elongation factor 2, leading to the inhibition of translational step of protein synthesis. Clostridium perfringens produce two kind of toxins. One is mesotoxin, one is minor toxins. Under mesotoxins comes alpha toxin, beta toxin, epsilon toxin, iota toxin. Alpha toxin is lethal. It has lecithinase phospholipase C activity. It is hemolytic. Beta lysine is lethal, necrotizing, trypsin labile. Epsilon toxin is lethal, permease, trypsin activable. Iota toxin is lethal, dermonecrotic. Then, after lototoxin, two fragments. Fragment A is the ADP ribosylating fragment. Fragment B is the binding fragment. Under minor toxins come gamma toxin, delta toxin, which is hemolysin, lambda toxin, which is protease activity, kappa toxin, which is collagenase and gelatinase activity, theta toxin, which is hemolysin, oxygen labile and cytolysin activity, eta toxin, mu toxin is hyaluronidase activity, nu toxin is deoxyribonuclease activity. Others such as neuraminidase makes the RBC pan-agglutinable, increases the blood viscosity and promote the capillary thrombosis. Coming to the exotoxins, alpha and theta toxin. Alpha toxin has phospholipase C and sphingomyelinase activity, as you have already seen. It activates the platelet adhesion molecule GP2B or 3A, causes platelets and neutrophil aggregation in the blood vessels leading to occlusion. It suppresses the myocardial contractility, reduces cardiac output, causing profound hypotension. It causes gas gangrene. Alpha toxin, hyaluronidase and lecithinase activity causes disruption of tissue integrity, causing tissue damage and necrosis. Carbohydrate fermentation by the bacteria in tissues causes gas production leading to gas gangrene. Theta toxin causes marked vasodilatation by activating the mediators like prostacycline, platelet activating factor. Clostridium perfringens type A enterotoxin. It is enterotoxic and cytotoxic. It is coded by CPE gene. It causes food poisoning between 8 to 16 hours after consumption of food. Mechanism of action is that Clostridium perfringens exotoxin binds to intestinal epithelium, forming pores in the intestinal mucosal membrane, leading to outflow of water and electrolytes into gut lumen, causing diarrhea. The diagnosis is by detection of enterotoxin in feces by enzyme immunoassay. Next class, we will be studying about the neurotoxins in detail. Thank you.